On Tuesday, March 23rd, San Francisco supervisors, community groups, and commissions held a press conference on the steps of City Hall to reiterate their opposition to Prop 16 and to publicly denounce the lies and distortions PG&E's flyers and TV commercials over Prop 16.
Good afternoon, folks. I think like many of you, I got this brochure over the weekend from PG&E, and it says, what is community choice aggregation? It says CC allows cities to replace the local private electric company as the provider of electric power with a government-run program. It makes you think that if your power goes out, you're going to call for a muni bus or something. That's not what we're talking about here at all. CCA is not about taking over PG&E. If you have a power problem in your house, PG&E will still come out and they will still take care of it. They will still own the transmission system and the distribution system. When you get a bill, it will come from PG&E. You will still pay it to PG&E. What CCA is about is Clean Power SF is going to buy a cleaner, more renewable mix of power and deliver that to PG&E so PG&E can deliver it to the homes and businesses in San Francisco. The initial idea is that we're going to buy that power. The long-term idea is that we're going to generate some of that power in San Francisco. It's the right thing to do.
In other words, Prop 16 would limit the city's ability to buy cheap renewable energy from other sources.
The most shameful, egregious acts that any corporation could do in this nation, but in particular in the state of California, is that PG&E wants to enshrine in our state constitution an amendment to the state constitution that now requires municipalities to seek a two-thirds vote of its people before it could pursue its hopes of amending its public power, pursue its ambitions, or become an energy aggregator. That's telling Sacramento, who has now been a public power entity for nearly 60 years after they evicted PG&E, that they now have to submit back to a two-thirds vote. While the trend, certainly statewide, is to inject common sense and eliminate the two-thirds requirements on how the budget, which has been in paralysis on the state level, back to a simple majority, PG&E, of course, in their infinite wisdom to subvert citizen democracy, wants to install a two-thirds vote, therefore giving a one-third minority power position. Many of us are congregated here today to say we in San Francisco are united through the Public Utilities Commission, through LAFCO, through many of us in the elected family to say that we are on a rapid course in pursuing our Clean Power San Francisco program.
Clean Power SF is a plan enacted in 2007 that provides a path to using clean, renewable, and affordable energy for every San Francisco resident and business.